Be strong, therefore, and be of good courage. For unto this people shall thou divide the inheritance of the land, which I swear unto their fathers to give them. Only be thou strong and very courageous. Remember yourself to do according to all the law which Moses thy servant commanded thee. And turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper in as well as I always. Praise God this morning. We want to go and pray. We know that the Lord has promised us the inheritance. We have come to the way together, that the inheritance must be shared. And for sure, because he who promised is faithful. So today, we want to pray for one of the threats to inheritance, so that we ask the Lord together. The Bible says, ask, ye shall receive, knock and the door shall be open, seek and you shall find. So today we want to ask you together, because of this threat to inheritance, and we ask the Lord to deliver us, to help us, to hold our heads, to lead us and to guide us, because it's a real threat. And this is the spirit of death. The spirit of death is a threat, is a big challenge to inheritance. And the Lord wants to deal with it today, and he wants us to call upon his name. You remember the children of Israel. There was threat of death. And the night of their deliverance, because that's the night that they received their inheritance, the Lord said, you will apply the blood on the doorposts. You keep the lamp, apply the blood on the doorposts. So the spirit of death is passing by. When he sees the blood, he will pass on. He will pass on. And that's what happened. When they applied the blood, when the spirit of death came, for sure, they were spared. And this morning, we are going to receive the lamb, receive the blood, apply it to your life. What does this mean? Where is the presence of God? There is no death. There is no infirmity. Is the Lord speaking? Is he out of his mind? When he is saying he is giving us inheritance, when we are challenged by the threat of the pandemic, is he out of his mind? No. The Bible says in Philippians, that in the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, those in heaven and of those on earth, and of those under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. So when the Lord is speaking of inheritance in the midst of a challenge of death, he is exalted. He is the one who conquered death. So when he says you're going to receive inheritance, he knows he keeps his life. And the life in fullness. So he is not out of his mind to say in the midst of the challenge of death that he's going to give us inheritance. Is there inheritance also in the grave? No. But the name of Jesus has been lifted high, has been exalted, that every knee shall bow, even death shall bow, of those in heaven and of those on earth, and of those under the earth, and that every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is indeed the Lord. Today, as you call upon the name of the Lord, because he is exalted, name of Jesus is exalted. He is a lamp that is come to make sure the bridging gap that for sure we shall pass from death to life. Not even passing from death to life, but receiving my inheritance. Today, as you come to pray, it shall be that every knee shall bow and know that our Jehovah is Jehovah Jireh, the God who provides even in times of need. Today, every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that in this Jehovah Rapha, He is the one who heals us. So He's going to heal us from our soul diseases. He's going to heal us from the vice of death and bring us to inheritance. Every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that He is Jehovah Nissi. The Lord will fight our battles. He is the Lord who fights our battles. Every knee and every tongue today must bow and confess that indeed He is Jehovah Shalom, our peace. Our peace. Without peace, there is no inheritance. He is Jehovah our way. Our shepherd, the Lord our shepherd today. Jehovah our Savior, our righteousness. So as you come to ask the Lord today, every knee must bow and bow, and every tongue confess that indeed is Jehovah Shalom, the God of mercy, the God who shall always be there for us. So this is going to be our promise. A promise of inheritance. A promise of inheritance in the midst of challenge. But the Lord is not challenged because He is God. So the name of Jesus is lifted high. High. To a point that we only bend our knee to the kings. He is exalted higher than any other king, than the rulers, than any other rulers. Why? He offered His blood. He conquered it. He sacrificed His life for us. So this morning the Lord is saying, fear not. I am with you. I conquered death, and I am He who promises my church that I will really release my inheritance to you. Therefore, this morning I want to rise, and I want to give you scripture. I want to use some strategy. Some strategy we can read it together. One of the scriptures that we are going to use to ask the Lord to deliver us from death. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me to beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for His name's sake. Yet, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I'll fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy Lord and thy staff will comfort me. Thou preparest a table, thou preparest me delights before me in the presence of thine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. So we'll use that scripture today. Let's also go to Psalms 46. Psalms 46. God is our refuge and a strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake the swelling thereof, there is a river, the streams whereof shall make it glad, the city of the Lord,
Jesus,
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 us from this evening. Like David, say to your heart, say it loud, I shall not die. I will live and declare the purposes of God. Confess that to the mouth this morning.
Because
Oh,